Dear viewers of Serbian television, with us is Hašajar Darvish. He's director of Dalai Lama Renaissance. How did you get the idea to do the movie?
Actually, I was asked. I had worked with the Dalai Lama on two past projects, and I was just asked for this film to come, to make the film.
And they said you had 140 hours of footage.
140, yes. We actually had we had 18 travel to India in our crew, and we had five cameras. And after we came back, we had a lot of footage to look through and search through.
When you work with five cameras, that's really hard, very challenging, right?
It's challenging to watch all the footage.
No, just like to choose the one that can show the best of the subjects.
Yes. Harrison Ford also is in the film. So he's the narrator of the film, mm-hmm. Harrison Ford.
And Dalai Lama called 40 people to give his opinion, their opinion, right, about the peace, about the problems in the world. And did you tape all the 40 people?
I let each person who was working the camera, they just sort of went on instinct and on basic directions, and they filmed what was important, you know, in their eyes.
So every cinematographer had a chance to be director in that for his little camera, and then you decided overall all five cameras were going to go for the final print, right?
Exactly. I had trust. You know, I chose the cameraman. You know, I knew had the right instinct, the right artistry, and you know I had trust.
Mm-hmm. And tell me, previous work. What did you do?
I did a film on the History Channel in the U.S. about a gold town that once had gold mining. The gold mining ran out, and they brought in gambling, which changed the whole town.
Again, gold, but different kind of gold.
Yeah. There's the spiritual gold, and there's the.
But again, golden rush, right? The golden rush. Everybody want to become rich, either gold or casinos or whatever.
Yes.
The destruction of balance, right?
Exactly. Actually, there is a gold.
How was the working with Dalai Lama?
Oh, he's a. He's a great spiritual person. You know, his presence really, really fills the room when you're with him. So I sat about 4 feet away from him, and I just, you know, I really felt the whole room fill with this presence of compassion and warmth. And everyone who spends time with him is impacted in some way. You know, they leave with some seed of transformation that was planted from being with him.
And so I'm going to cut. Probably for your viewers will be interesting to ask director Hašajar Darvish about future about this movie. We heard that has the opportunity to be also an Academy nominee, right?
It was just entered into the Oscars for the spring. So it's playing actually in theaters in the U.S. So it's played in 18 cities so far. It's playing also overseas. So it's screening in Taiwan. It'll be in Austria, Switzerland, Germany, and some other places overseas. Mm-hmm. But it's going to be. It actually is an official entry now into the Academy Awards.
That's amazing. That's a really great recognition for your work. How many films are in that category?
60 or so.
60? And then final five get a chance to be, you know,
nominated.
One of those nominated, right. So out of 60, so your film is already in the top 60, right, for this category?
So far.
Okay, that's so really, really great. Great news. And so basically about your plans. You're going to different festival now, promoting your film, working on some maybe new ideas.
Well, it's already been in a lot of festivals. It's been in 40 film festivals around the world. So now I'm just really traveling with the film as it plays in cities and overseas, just doing promotion. Mm-hmm. But I always do films that have a positive message. So I feel like it's the only films that are really worth doing are films that serve some higher higher purpose or message.
Bring something, good feelings and good ideas and maybe some kind of solution, how to deal with daily world, et cetera, from day to day. And about you, like, where do you find the funding for the movie? How did you find? Because it's all directors say, oh, I would like to do this and that movie, but always funding is a problem. How did you solve that problem?
Well, I had some private donors. I had some grants. But I really feel like if you feel passionate about a project, if a project is really important to you, then you'll find the funding for it. You know, I would rather actually start a project that I believe passionately in, even if all the funding isn't there. You know, I believe if you have the commitment and passion that you'll get the film done and you'll share it with audiences.
And we would like to wish you to find all great inspiration around you, more positive messages and good ideas how to bring the peace to Earth, because the film festival is peace on Earth, right?
Yes, the Peace on Earth, Film Festival. Yeah. And the world needs more peace.
Definitely. Okay, we are talking here peacefully. We hope we're going to bring more peace in our daily environment, and hopefully everyone should think about how to make life a little better and more pleasant, not for themselves, but also for people around, right?
Absolutely.
That's a key. Make other people happy, and then probably other people are going to make you happy too.
Exactly. That's actually a message of the Dalai Lama, that real peace in the world starts with yourself first. It actually is a message of the film, that if you want to change the world, you have to first change yourself. And that change is gonna impact others around you, your friends and family, and it sort of grows like a stone thrown in a pond, like circles of change and positive transformation that extend outward.
So, when you finish with watching the program, when you finish watching the television, just look yourself in the mirror and ask a question yourself. What can you do to make yourself a better person? Make people more happy around you, and that's its first movement to, you know, honor this film festival. You know, and the film festival is a peace on Earth, right?
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.